I'm back in my little cozy bakery, discussing today the Jobcentre issue, and all this week we will be discussing the Jobcentre, maybe the first 2-3 days. The file for you. So, what is this all about today? What is hiding inside the question? What is the question? The answer is the question. Oh, it was a pretty deliberate thing what happened on the job center. Unlawful detention by the security staff and a stitch-up, literal stitch-up. And they keep continuing to do it. So I received a letter. It's from the overseer who is overseeing the office, the department. Just try to find very quickly. It's called Government Legal Department. So Jobcentre Newport contacted these guys, Government Legal Department. They're based in London, Westminster, and I received a ban from entering the premises, not just the Jobcentre Newport, but all surrounding area, all local areas. So Abertery, Beggaron, Berry, Blackwood, Caerphilly, Caldicot, Cardiff, Chepstow, Cumbram, Abbeville, Pontypool, Penarth, Newport, Merthyr. So I am basically banned from all these premises just because of a very simple reason, because of their cover-up, what they wanna do. They cannot cover it up already. There is already audio documentation and video documentation as well. So if we jump quickly into this letter, as obvious as usually, I always will be posting it on the Facebook as well. So Department of Work and Pension, Jobcentre Plus, banning letter. Please read carefully. We act for the Department for Work and Pension, Jobcentre Plus. They have instructed us to write to you. Jobcentre Plus wrote to you on 29th of November 2019 regarding an incident of unacceptable behavior on 28th of November 2019. A copy of this letter is enclosed for ease of reference. Despite being warned, you have committed further acts of unacceptable behavior, unknown to me. We are instructed that on 1st of December 2019 you posted a video on YouTube which contained a footage of you possession of an air weapon. During this footage you also made comments that were considered to be a threatening nature towards the staff of the Jobcentre Plus. On 16th of December 2019 you attended a screened area of Newport Jobcentre Plus in light of the above video that you posted online. The police were called to attend the incident and found you to be in possession of a weapon. You were arrested and taken into the custody. So we are seeing here literal how the job center is spreading phony jobs, phony thing. They spreading misinformation and they trying to put some shades on me. This is all lies. There be no weapons, anything like that in the premises. Continue. So you must not enter the above Jobcentre Plus offices for any reason during this period of half year. This ban does not prevent the bringing of a criminal or civil proceedings in respect of the behavior which has given rise to this letter. Jobcentre Plus might decide that the other control measures to address your behavior should be imposed. Right. It continues. This is not important anymore. It's just 2 points, but the thing is that I've been banned from entering And not just that, the second part of this video will be coming tomorrow because it's pretty late now. And I will be doing the second part of stopping my money basically from them, again on unjustified reasons. And I basically, what I will be doing now, I am formally requesting a lift of this ban in this document. Formal request, request the review of the case and lift of the ban order. And it says, letter issued and signed by the Treasury Solicitor on 19 of December 2019, issuing my ban from Jobcentre Plus branches is based on misinformation and deliberate cover-up of gross misconducts, human rights abuse and assault on my person following by unlawful and unjustified detention conducted by the staff of the Jobcentre Plus. Crime report with supporting evidence including audio recording and CCTV footage being submitted to the police department in Newport on 28th of November 2019. In your letter issuing ban, you stating that the trash movie posted on YouTube by my person was threatening to the staff of the Jobcentre, but in the police interview after my detention been all cleared up and this false accusation proven that it have no relation to the Jobcentre, not even remotely. The trash movie was aimed as a sarcastic comedy on completely different topic. I want also highlight that in your letter you are stating that on the detention day 16 of December 2019 at Jobcentre, I've been in possession of a weapon. This is a misinformation and complete lie, and I will not be even released from the cell in such a case, given the fact about the very strict laws United Kingdom in regards of weapon possession in a public space. I also want to raise a concern about the internal functioning of the Jobcentre Plus, specifically the Newport branch on the 2 to 6 Charles Street, beside the deliberate cover-up which might result in a serious charges of conspiracy against my person. The department failed to respond to my complaint, formal request and following with reminder submitted by me on 2nd December 2019. The department completely disregard the facts of breach of human rights, ignoring the correspondence and its spreading lies, including the letters aimed to deceive the government legal department itself. I am attaching documents supporting my claims to this formal request for you to review, which includes release and notification letter from the police department, crime report, assault and unlawful detention, police department, complaint submitted to the Jobcentre Newport, official request to gain permission to record Jobcentre hearings, informal reminder of not meeting the reasonable timelines for documentation and responses. It's all here. We have it all here, ladies and gentlemen, in this file. The supporting evidence as well. So this is here the formal request, response on the ban, the release under investigation, notification, crime report, complaint to the Jobcentre, official request, reminder, all ignored, all documentation of mine being ignored, gross misconducts. Time to finish my cake. I'm gonna post something. Yes, presidential class, please. Thank you.